Well, this goes back quite a way. I started falling about 10 years ago. And I'd be walking along and all of a sudden I would be on the ground and I couldn't figure out what was going on. So I did chiropractic and I started doing Pilates and I would still just randomly fall. I had no idea of what was wrong, but it was like my mind and my body were not working together. And it gradually got worse. It's a miracle that I haven't broken something. And I did do a knee replacement on my left side, on my left knee. And I'm still, I thought that would take care of the falling. And of course it did not. And somehow or other, I don't really even remember how. I think it was my chiropractor and I talked about stem cell rather than fusion of my disc, because that's what the medical people wanted me to do. I made contact with you, mm-hmm. and we started the PRP, and I realized that was working, but I just felt like my life was going by too fast. I didn't want to spend a year doing PRP. So I came to you and I said, look, we need to speed this thing up. I'm running out of time. And we set a date for the stem cell therapy, the actual umbilical cord stem cells, and which I said, listen, if we're going to do this, you do the best. You pick the best cells, okay?
Yep, yep.
And my procedure lasted probably an hour. You did the PRP plus the embryonic,
the mesenchymal umbilical.
Yeah, the umbilical cells. And there were probably 30 injections.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going into depth here a little bit because the main thing is I didn't feel any pain.
Yeah.
It was not a painful experience.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that, I don't think that I'm that different than most other folks. So if anybody is really thinking about this, I want them to know there was no pain. There probably could have if I thought there might be.
Yeah.
But I didn't have that fear, and it was a very simplistic procedure. I will tell you, I felt a little lightheaded at the end. And then I went in for my first IV vitamin infusion, which at first I didn't want to sign up for. That was an expensive amount of money. I am so hooked on the vitamin infusions, I don't think I'll ever come off of them.
Yeah.
It's money well spent, and it has just increased my ability to think clearly, to operate my body. My body has just gained in strength and stability, and I just have so much more, I just feel 20 or 30 years younger. I just feel like this is great. This is the ticket. It's worth it, whatever it is, whatever you're charging. I'm not going to say what you're charging now because you may have to charge more later on. But it's just a wonderful investment in prolonging productive life.
Yeah. Go back to the symptoms that you had, the imaging that you brought in, you know, from the spondylolisthesis to the spinal stenosis to the shooting things down both legs.
I was in a, besides going through the mental feeling like, can I do this? Every time I walked, I wondered if I was gonna be on the ground. And that was just becoming a terrible burden. I mean, that was just consuming. It was like trying to run with an umbrella. You know, it was just really an effort to get beyond my mental confusion of whether I could stay upright or not. I had that going on. My back hurt constantly, the lower part around the L4 and the L5. This area of my leg was constantly in pain. My feet were hurting. My ankles were hurting. I could not, but when I, the last 6 weeks before I came in for this treatment, this sounds a little gross, and if you want to blot it out, you can. it was hard for me to maintain my own personal sanitation. It was really getting difficult. My range of motion was so restricted that to even turn around or bend down to tie my shoes, I mean, I got to the point where I thought I may have to hire somebody to come in and help me with my own personal needs. So, yeah, I was getting pretty close to zero. My self-confidence has always been pretty good. I was starting to second guess myself in almost every area of my life. So, yeah, this was huge.
Yeah, big turning moment. And how long for periods of time could you sit? Because you know, I think you told me like you booked a flight to Cuba and a trip to Alaska for, you know, getting on helicopters. How you're able to sit on that plane for longer periods of time?
Since my injections, I flew to Hawaii. What was it, about a month after I had my treatment?
Yeah.
I'm bad with
dates.
I'm just really bad with it. But it was a short time afterwards. Maybe it was 5 weeks, but it wasn't very long.
Mm-hmm.
And for us, it's a 5-hour flight. And that was, I was expecting the worst. I thought, man, I'm going to have to aisle seat. I need to be up and down constantly, which I did. I was up and down trying to move my body every hour for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And I got off that plane and I was in pretty good shape. And that was when I went on the helicopter trip. And that was fun. You know, it's kind of, God, I can still do it. I'm still alive. I can still kick ass. So I was able to take pictures while we were in flight. And afterwards, I was able to physically climb down off out of the helicopter without being an old lady. You know, everybody wants to put their hands out there. I can do it myself. So, yeah, that was big. That was huge for me because before that, remember, I just told you I couldn't even bend over to tie my shoe.
Yeah.
This was a huge revelation for me. And it just keeps getting better.
It just keeps getting better.
Thinking about going back to golf.
Yeah.
Haven't swung a club in a long time.
You can drive it 400 yards, right?
I used to be able to hit it pretty good. I don't know if I can or not. It's all in the swing, you know.
It's all in the hips. It's all in the low back. That's great. Your story is amazing. Thank you for coming and allowing and having the confidence in me to provide you more time. And the biggest thing that impacted me was you said, Dr. Jason, like, you 79. Today's your birthday, right?
Yep.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
I saw that. I was just like,
79 today.
Wow. 79 today. So then I always tell most patients, I'm like, how much percentage do you say you're feeling better after the injections? And you said you couldn't put a subjective number on it. You were like 78 at the time, and I feel like I'm in my younger 50s.
I feel just as good today. Actually, we might drop it down to the 40s pretty soon.
I love it. So that's the most important, just the quality of life that you live. And that's what I enjoy the most, is helping patients do the things they love to do.
And you know, Dr. Jason, there's just one thing I just have to say. For anybody who's listening to this tape, first of all, I haven't been paid. But secondly, there's two parts to this. There are the stem cells, but then there's the person who is injecting. And I can't believe I had no pain. And you injected without, you looked at my MRI and you knew where to put that injection. And I could feel you moving your fingers and stuff around on my body. And I'm sure it was sensing the temperature of my skin. But you have a gift. The magic fingers, you know, it sounds a little bit like a porno flick, but it's true. You've got healing in your touch. And I don't know how many people have signed up for therapy, but this is really important. And I don't think everybody has that. I think it's really your gift, and I'm thankful for whatever it took you to get to this point. And I thank you for administering that to me, because I just feel like I've reclaimed my life. And it has not really been anything I've done. It's what you brought into my life, and I'm just reaping the benefits. So thank you.
Thank the cells. And yeah, thank you for that. That's
really it's the kind truth. You know, yeah. You don't lie about stuff like this.
You can't lie about the world. No. This is why this video needs to be out there.
Yeah.